I'm Dr. Adel Zurob, a pulmonologist and critical care physician with Mayo Clinic Health System, and I'm here to address questions you may have about robotic-assisted bronchoscopy. It's not any different than a regular bronchoscopy from your perspective. So basically, you're fasting from midnight the night before. Obviously, we want you off any blood thinners because we don't want to poke something that's going to bleed, more likely to bleed. And then you're asleep for the procedure. So we have to have you still, otherwise our map is going to vary too much. So you have to be still, you're asleep. And then the procedure itself will take about an hour, give or take, depending on how complex the lesion we're going after. And then once we're done, we wake you up in the room, we take out the tube, you know, and you go back to recovery where we watch you for about an hour or so, and then you go home. The risks are not much different than a regular bronchoscopy. If anything, they are often less because we're using more precise technology to get to where we want. But there are risks. There's nothing without risk. Anytime we poke something, it can bleed, but the risk of a life-threatening bleed is very minimal. Anytime we take a biopsy or poke the lung, it can collapse. We can puncture it, it can collapse. But that risk is also small, 5% or less. And then obviously, you know, we don't anticipate that patients are going to get worse after the procedure and that they have to stay overnight on a ventilator, but occasionally it happens. But that again is not a common thing. It's pretty rare. So all in all, you come for your procedure, you're here for a few hours, then you go home. And there's no more to it as far as recovery. You still can go to work the next day. To learn more, please click on one of the links on the screen or the description below.